Hey guys, I'm Aaron and I'm here in Bluff, Utah at the University of Utah's Design Build campus. We're going to spend some time with Hiroko and Atsushi, and we're going to see how their Design Build program works to create a residence that was built in SketchUp.
Each year, this graduate architectural program collaborates with the Navajo Nation to design and build a project in southern Utah. One of the instructors, Hiroko, gave me a tour of this remote campus where they live and work. You heard me right. The students all moved down to Bluff for the semester.
This is a little different from a lot of college programs.
The unique thing is that the students, the same students, will keep going to the end. Mm-hmm. So they start creation of the concept and then give the key to the client.
So this is actually the second semester mm-hmm. of this program. The first semester yes. they were in Salt Lake City right. and that was the design portion. That's where they were the boring new software indoors part. But that was where they were actually learning yes. the process of design. Yeah. Can yes. you tell us a little bit about what that's
yeah.
like?
Yeah. The first couple weeks we just focus on the culture or history, but we start like, what is important? What's the concept of the project? They do interview and the survey for the site to understand this culture, so they learn.
Yeah, you're very intentional about spending time with the client, learning about the Navajo Nation, learning about the people they're building for. They shouldn't assume that whatever they want is what the customer actually wants, the client actually needs.
Architecture things is like really similar like cooking. Mm-hmm. Our style is more like we do barbecue style, so everyone, you know, non-skilled or skilled or homeowners, we just bring the materials and then prepare it, build it, and then cook it and eat together. So come to learn together.
All this cooking talk's got me hungry. Wait till you see what I cooked up later.
It's time to head out to the site. I'm super excited to get a chance to see what they've been working on for the last couple months and maybe see if there's a place I can help out myself. Let's go. About 15 minutes from the campus to Herman and Judy's place where they're actually building the new house. So here we're going to get a chance to walk around, see what they're building, and talk to some of the students about their experience. This is going to be fun. This is where we see how things are really getting built.
I caught up with Atsushi, the other instructor, to walk the site. It was so cool to learn that even though this is not a traditional building site, they still have very real design limitations.
This is based on the academic the calendar of the University of Utah, so we have a completion day.
So you have a deadline.
Yes.
Gotta get done.
It's always a deadline, right. And the student works so hard to like complete this project.
Yeah. Notice all the trusses came in two parts
yes.
and have to be scabbed
yes.
and put together. And that was because of the limitation of the trailer?
Yes. We have some limitation. The lengthwise, we only ask them to use only 8 feet long. Mm. And also the weight is also two people.
Right.
Yeah.
There's no cranes.
Can carry. No yeah. crane. And if it's like more than that, we cannot use it. Big difference between the design build in the city or mm-hmm. design build in a rural area. I'm really happy to work together with them to design the affordable house. That is also helpful for the local community. Sorry, it's I put the alarm for the safety check. Can I do it right
oh, yeah.
now?
Go ahead, let's
okay.
hear it.
Yeah. Everyone, like... 11 a.m. safety check.
I'll do my safety check.
Student is in charge of one piece of the construction.
The exterior roof and water catchment system.
Plumbing.
The foundation.
Expansion plan.
The window locations.
The HVAC system.
The exterior siding.
The interiors for the house.
Trusses.
We all really cared about making sure that this was something that Herman wanted. We were meeting his needs, but we sort of sometimes disagreed on how to do that. I think that was the hardest part for me in design was I know we all cared the same way, but figuring out how to turn that care into a house.
I'm Aaron.
I'm Herman.
Nice to meet you. This is your home.
Yeah.
This is my first house too.
It's there, it's real.
Yeah, yeah.
He built a tarp for us, mm-hmm. and also a refrigerator, all the accommodations. He spoiled us.
Yeah.
And then second week, he wore his safety vest, and then he joined the concrete spreading crew.
Do a little troll like this, wow. and you know.
It was great, yeah.
That's pretty amazing.
My RV is too small.
Well, this is definitely a step up.
Yep, I like it.
That's great.
It's great. Yeah, they say good morning. Yate bene. They say that in the morning too. Yeah. Navajo.
Yate a bene.
Yeah.
Woo. Yeah. I learned something. Thank you.
I like how visual the progress is right now, because like the first 3 weeks we were doing the foundation.
When it gets to the framing part, you actually see things really show up, like a day of work looks like something happened.
It just forms the actual house. When I started the undergrad, I didn't know any software. So learning SketchUp was very, very easy and very, very informative. And I love all the plugins that it has, and it has compatibility with any other software, which is great. For this project, I've used it to design the sun blades and the window locations, using Sapphire to get an understanding of the daylighting, like how much you need to change the elevation of the windows and locations of it.
Mm-hmm. We'll catch up with Dylan later.
I'm going back to school later in life. Basically, do I love this enough to feel stupid in front of people less than half my age? And yeah, the answer was yes, so I'm doing it. I honestly am not that great at SketchUp, so I'm just going to be honest, but SketchUp and Sapphire work seamlessly together. And for someone like me to say that, it's a thumbs up.
A little bit down the road when I am sitting behind that desk and I'm thinking a little bit more of the contractor now or the trade. I know sometimes there's a little bit of buffer between those fields, but as an architect, I'll be like, okay, I understand why you can't move that plumbing pipe, for example.
Right.
I will change my design a little bit and meet you in the middle.
I got to talk to Noreen and he told me about the difference between working in an architecture firm versus working here.
Most of the in the field experience that I have, like most of us never met the client. Like it was basically like project managers, and this is the first time I actually interacted with the client, and it was a good experience. Yeah.
Good. Did you have you used? Sorry.
You're good.
There's a bug on the back of my head.
Welcome to site.
So, what's been so far your favorite part about this project?
I think, in all sincerity, it's really getting to know the homeowner and being able to build a relationship with them and being able to build a home with them, for them, and just kind of seeing their excitement along the process.
Almost every year, no matter what's happened, the client cried. Homeowner cried.
I cry for it too.
Yeah.
Shed my tears. We're gonna have a house, dream house.
That's great.
Yeah.
At first it was kind of like surprising and shocking for us. For 700 square foot, we were like, we can't fit anything. But now we're like, yeah, we can fit this too. We can fit that too. Yeah. And we have to be like flexible with our design. So if anything happens, we can change some items.
That's a good thing to learn too. Have a plan B.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm the semi-professional pizza chef now. But that.
After experiencing the barbecue style of learning and living here, I really came to appreciate the incubation of community, woo, apprenticeship, and a compassion for those who need housing. The day wasn't over yet. After dinner, we all went down to the studio where the students discussed their ideas for taking natural materials and making them into tiles for a design exercise.
Yeah, pretty square. And is that kitten, is that yours?
Yeah.
That's called the ceremony basket. And then, you know, like that.
And then Dylan sat down with me to talk about some interesting design aspects of the project.
Basically, in the beginning of last semester, we split into three groups that each designed their own floor plan. And then during the midterm, we kind of combined everything all together. So this is kind of essentially a combination of three different projects coming together.
Wow, you wouldn't know that. I mean, everything, you guys blended everything very well. It's seamless by the time it's done.
We couldn't make these studs small enough, smaller than pretty much this that is over here. So we couldn't push the windows further up.
Yeah, nothing messes with a perfect design like reality.
Yeah, for sure. We're learning that firsthand now. But that in return gave us the access to allow for this to be like an emergency exit in return. So yeah, because it's only 2 feet off the ground, they can use it as an emergency exit. And then it having more light into the space, primarily the kitchen. Mm-hmm. And that's where we kind of like added this big window there to kind of accommodate for that. Because originally our door kind of had a window in it, and this window didn't exist. The idea was to keep the view towards the east because that's something that the clients wanted. Mm-hmm. But after the issue with the lighting not coming deep enough from the south, we added this one as well. So it was a constant receiving of feedback through the renders, through the model, and through the ideas that we had. Every time we had a meeting throughout the semester, we showed them updated versions of the renders, which really helped them understand how the project is coming together, how it's gonna look, if they like the colors, if they like the layout, pretty much everything. We use SketchUp primarily to make design decisions and figure out what we could do.
That was awesome. I can say I was not expecting to cook a wood fire pizza when I came here, but getting to do that and spend time with all these students, learn more about them, see them in their community together, and how building a home was more to them than just a design project. They actually getting on site and using their hands and creating something that was important to somebody else, just an amazing experience. I can't wait to see what they do next, and I can't wait to see you next time. See ya.